Down the decades, Pakistan has persisted with the lie that they have no idea about the whereabouts of India's number one terrorist, Daud Ibrahim. But now it has been established. Daud is in Karachi with his entire brood, his entire family. In fact, Times Now has tracked him down in the city. Here is an audio clip of how our team spoke to Daud's wife, who confirmed that he remains in Pakistan.
Assalamu alaikum.
Hello.
Assalamu alaikum.
Waalaikum.
आपा से बात कराइए, मेरे फोन पे बात नहीं हो रही है.
कौन सी आपा से बात कर रही है?
आपा, मैं जब भी आपा से बात कर ली है.
नहीं नहीं है, यहाँ पर आपको बहुत दुख है.
अच्छा, अभी आपने पहले से बात हुई थी इसलिए मैं आपसे फोन किया ना. पहले आपसे बात हुई थी, आपने बात की थी इसलिए मैंने बोला.
बात
अच्छा, तो फिर ये आपका नाम क्या है?
मेरा नाम अनम है.
अच्छा, आपका नाम अनम है. ये मेरा नाम काशिफ है, मुझे आपा से बात करनी थी. मैजबिन आपा नहीं है अभी?
नहीं है भैया, नहीं है.
अच्छा, तो आपको कुछ पता है नंबर कहाँ पे मिल सकती है कुछ?
नहीं पता
है. अच्छा ठीक है, ठीक है, शुक्रिया.
हेलो, अस्सलाम वालेकुम.
हेलो, वालेकुम अस्सलाम. क्या मैं मेजबीन शेख से बात कर रहा हूँ?
जी.
मैडम, आप कराची से बोल रहे हैं?
जी. जी, आप कौन?
जी मैडम, मुझे बस पूछना था, आप मिस्टर दाऊद इब्राहिम की बीवी हैं?
जी, बस हो रहे.
Let me go back to my guests, Ambassador Neelam Deo, General Giri Bakshi and Rashni Kher. It's amusing that Pakistan would like the whole world to believe that for them, Kashmir was the main issue. That was the breaking point. That's why they don't want to go ahead with the talks. Where even yesterday, when Mr. Sartaj Aziz was speaking about the dossier that Ajit Doval has put together, he refrained from making any comment on it because he doesn't really have any answers, does he, General Bakshi? It's been established. Daud is and has
absolutely
been in Karachi
not
under the protection and patronage of the ISI.
You know, the fact of the matter is that Pakistan, you know, we all had thought that after the massacre of the children in Peshawar, there was a deep, deep-seated rethink in Pakistan about the desirability of continuing with their policy of using terror as a tool. But unfortunately, they have learnt no lessons. They have learnt nothing. They still are trying to distinguish between the good Taliban, the bad Taliban. They have tried to win kudos from the Americans by launching their Operation Zarb-e-Azm to flush out the so-called terrorists from Fatah and the Northwest Frontier Province. But the actual fact is they have taken no action against the Lashkar-e-Toyba, against the Jaish-e-Mohammed, against the Hizbul Mujahideen, against the Indian Mujahideen, all India-centric groups that thrive on patronage of the Pakistani ISI and the army. And you know, Dawood is the chief logistician. He has been providing the networks of information, logistics and support for each and every terrorist operation that the Pakistan ISI has launched against India. He is their kingpin, their linchpin in Pakistan. And
so let me
as
put that question to Pakistani journalist Mr. Mayed Ali, is also joining us live. Mr. Mayed Ali, you want to tell the whole world that you're acting against terrorists, but it's only the bad terrorists who you seem to be targeting in your Operation Zarb-e-Azm, where the good terrorists continue to be in the plush localities of Karachi. He's got at least three addresses, two of them in Clifton, in the company of diplomats and senior politicians. Apparently, one of his houses is right next to that of the late Mrs. Benazir Bhutto's son.
May I know your name?
My name is Padmuja.
Padmuja, good morning.
Good morning.
Padmuja, I have a colleague by the name Shahid Aslam. I would ask you, I would request you to give me his location in say 1 month. Can you?
I'm sorry, could you be a bit louder? I can't hear you very clearly.
You won't hear me now.
No,
I have a colleague.
I'll be able to hear you. I
have a colleague by the name of Shahid Aslam who works with me. I want you to trace his residence where he lives, and I give you 1 month. Please trace him. I am surprised. Please write down the name. I am surprised.
Yes, I've written down your name.
You can't.
And your point is?
My point is that I don't know how you come up with stories. I don't know what Roy is doing, what you're doing. How could a channel find somebody like that?
Exactly how that was possible. You've issued passports to him, sir.
Please develop the habit of listening.
Is it not a fact that Dawood Ibrahim's wife, his son, his daughter, his son-in-law have got passports issued to them, legitimate passports. They've been flying in and out of the airport at Karachi, and no one in your government knows that they're living in Clifton.
Yeah. That's the point I'm trying to understand, that high profile terrorist in your opinion and also in mine, a high profile person like Dawood Ibrahim, you have got access to his wife, his home, his numbers and everything. And the ISI is sleeping. This is what you want me to believe. And you want me to believe.
The ISI is making sure that they are getting complete patronage.
Please, let me complete.
Yes, go ahead.
I'm tired of this thing. That you put words on people's mouth, you take a position,
no one is putting words in your mouth. I will give you a very logical answer to that. You are not in a position to put any word in my mouth. You've asked a question, Mayad Ali. Let me get our guest. We have a valid point of view. Ambassador Neelam Deo, would you like
respond.
To answer these doubts that
let
Mr. Mayad Ali is raising?
Let me
because he again is saying these are just figments of someone's imagination. The passports, the addresses, the phone bills.
I think that everybody knows what the activities of the ISI are. After all, the government of Pakistan has pretended for years that they didn't know that Osama bin Laden lived in Pakistan. They have now announced that 2 years ago, Mullah Omar of the Taliban died in a hospital. Kabul has said that he died in a hospital in Karachi. They are still pretending they didn't know. Everybody in the world knows that Dawood Ibrahim has been living in Karachi for years. But the government of Pakistan and, journalists and its strategic analysts will continue to insist that they don't know. If they don't know anything at all, I think it's pretty worthless that we ask them for their opinion on anything.
Pakistani diplomat who had said that Dawood has now left Pakistan. So was he imagining Dawood's presence in Pakistan to begin with?
Let me respond to the colleague I heard. You've asked a fairly lengthy question,
Mr. Mayad Ali. Please wait to listen to the answers to that as well. Yes, General G.D. Bakshi.
Mayad, are you telling me that Osama bin Laden was not in Ahmedabad, 800 meters from the Pakistan Military Academy, Kabul? Are you telling me that Mullah Omar was not in Quetta? Are you telling me that Sirajuddin Haqqani is not in Peshawar? Are you telling me that Gulbuddin Hekmatyar is not in Pakistan? At one stage, Hamid Karzai had very rightly quipped that America fought the war in the wrong country. It is your country that the operations should have been conducted, because every conceivable terrorist leader who is responsible for murders and crimes against humanity all over the globe is in Pakistan. And Dawood Ibrahim is one of your prized assets of the ISI. What has been done now is that our people have been able to trace him back again. You have heard for yourself his wife talking on the on the mobile phone with our correspondent, saying Sahab is sleeping.
I have heard that.
I mean, do you need any further proof?
I need a lot of proof, and I don't understand how a person with of your stature could believe such things. Where is Raw, sir? Where is Raw? If the Times now is doing doing all this work, where is Raw? Where is ISI? Do you understand the level of understanding of the whole issue? To
well, Raw has in fact got its hand on the latest picture.
Please,
it has got its hand on the latest picture on Dawood Ibrahim. And we have the phone bill that you had issued to his wife.
If you will interfere,
Rashneek can want to make a point. Yes, Rashneek. Sir, please, you've asked questions about what Raw is doing. Now, please also give you the answer.
Mayad Sahib, I will very humbly make a point. Mayad Sahib, Mayad Ali Sahab, I'll make a very, very simple point. Javed Miadad lives in Pakistan or he doesn't live in Pakistan?
He does.
If Javed Miadad lives in Pakistan, that is how
he said he does. He lives in Pakistan.
He became the relative of Dawood Ibrahim. How did he become the relative of Dawood Ibrahim? Tell me. Where did the son and the daughter meet, sir? If not in Pakistan.
Dawood Ibrahim.
Forget ISI. Use common sense, sir.
Sir, you don't understand my point. My point is that Dawood Ibrahim is a very high profile person.
And
whosoever he is, he's a very high profile person. And whatever charges that you have leveled against him.
So was Osama bin Laden. So was Osama bin Laden. But he was Raw today has a telephone bill. Raw has passports of their sons. And let me tell you, sir, there is a man called Badshah Khan, who was one of the bombers in Mumbai bombings, who clearly told our intelligence agencies when he was caught that Dawood Ibrahim is in Karachi. Tiger Memon's brother came and told us that Dawood Ibrahim and Tiger Memon are in Karachi. I mean, these are people who have traveled to Pakistan via Dubai and they have come back and told us all these information, sir. It is not as if we are saying for hearsay.
I believe that we are on totally different frequencies. The point I am trying to make, I am not saying anything in defense of Dawood Ibrahim or what he is doing. I am trying to make a point that a person of his profile cannot be traced like that by a TV channel. And
is he in Karachi or not? Mr. Mayad Ali, answer the simple question. Is he in Karachi or
by an agency? Okay. For argument's sake, even if Padmaja, for argument's sake, even if the TV channel did not trace him, but are you saying the Raw also did not trace his phone bills or the passport copies of himself, of his families? Can Raw be so useless that they have found the wrong passports or they have picked up the wrong people or this information coming from Tiger Memon Brother was also wrong?
Raw is professional, and I won't say that.
Why are you hiding behind this premise of Times now not having found him? That is something that
why
you
should
know.
Why you keep on using
Times
words
now
like hiding in
the
like
number
that.
Of which the
we
copy is
hiding.
Available in press
not,
today?
Okay, you. But I'm sick of this. We are hiding. We are thieves.
No, you are not. No, but Dawood Ibrahim is. You are not. You are hiding behind a premise. You are using Times Now's telephone conversation as a premise to say that he is not
Muslims
here.
Are bothering
but what
you?
About Raw? They have brought out all the passport copies. They have brought out phone numbers. They have brought the address. They have a picture of him.
You keep on hurling such things at us.
Come again, sir. I did not hear what you said.
Behave.
For 7.
Terrorist. Blah.
No,
blah,
for 700
blah.
Years, Pakistan no. hasn't existed, sir. Pakistan has existed not even for 70 years.
Try that. This is if wishes were horses, Pakistan never is. Pakistan is here to stay, and we'll see what you can do about that.
No, no, Mr. Mayad Ali, again, simple one-line question. Is Dawood
God
Ibrahim
bless you,
in Karachi
sir. God
or not?
Bless you. I hope you exist as a civilized nation and not as
exactly.
a terrorist nation.
And it would be a
civilized.
Good beginning
we
if you start by
you.
Admitting that Dawood is in Karachi.
We don't kill people in Gujarat. We don't kill people in
the
Mumbai.
The familiar
we don't have nationalized. We don't kill people in Nagaland. We don't kill people everywhere else.
Sir,
we don't
do not bother.
Sir,
please do not bother. Let
sir,
us go as far
sir,
as Nagaland
sir,
and Gujarat.
Sir,
let's
you are killing. Sir, you are killing people in Baluchistan every day. You are killing people in Fata, and you have 21 amendment.
So are you, sir?
The military courts
so
to preside over civilian cases.
One,
this does not happen
one,
in any civilized democracy. We are not doing this. So please don't teach us. Please don't teach us human rights. You are a very reasonable man. I have a lot of respect for you, Mayad Ali Saab. But please don't start behaving like one of those generals who come on the television. Please, for God's sake, you are a very, very, very good man, sir.
Rashnik, just a second.
I'm sorry,
Mr. Mayad Ali, I started by asking you the simple question. You agree that Dawood Ibrahim, after all this documentation that has come out, is in Karachi?
I said that I am not sure where he is. I swear, I can tell you on oath where he is. I am a journalist.
Sir, I am telling you that we have
a
dossier. We have a dossier. The National Security Advisor has prepared a dossier, which is the real reason why you were so apprehensive about coming for talks. A dossier that states very clearly that yes, Dawood Ibrahim is in Karachi. There is no doubt left about that. General G.D. Bakshi.
Fine, then take the case up wherever you can.
Mayad,
it's your right.
Mayad, kindly. Mayad, can I hope after this you will not start denying that Hafiz Saeed is not in Pakistan. And I
he
hope you know that Hafiz Saeed has a 10
General
million
Bakshi,
bounty.
General Bakshi.
You know, put on his
General
head
Bakshi,
by the
sir.
United States. I hope you know that he is a designated global terrorist. I hope tomorrow you will not deny that he is Hafiz Saeed in Pakistan.
General Bakshi, can I respond?
Please.
Hafiz Saeed is in Pakistan. He is here. He's got all the powers that you claim. And he does whatever he does. You know that. And I don't have to go into details. He is here. And I know where he is. And whatever you say is right, and I agree. But the point is, let me make a point. Hafiz Saeed is not as powerful as you portray him. Number one, Hafiz Saeed doesn't have the kind of following that you think. He hails from the sect, and you know that very well. You're a learned person, that he hails from a sect which forms 20% of this country. How much following could he have? There are people who are living there in houses. These people have taken arms, they have resorted to all these things because of America, which you keep on quoting. Osama bin Laden was America's product. We are facing all this trouble because of Ziaulhaq and because of America. This country was not like this when Zulfikar Bhutto was here, and you know that very well. And we now, for the first time in 20 years, now let me complete.
Mayad, can I respond?
But let me complete. Now, for the first time in 20 years, I have this hope that this gentleman who is heading our army might go to the extent of taking on Hafiz Saeed one day. He has taken on people we thought would have never been.
But Mr. Mayad Ali, how will he take on Hafiz Saeed when he is as important an instrument of policy against India as Dawood Ibrahim? The reason why he is being sheltered, Dawood Ibrahim is being sheltered, is the same reason as Hafiz Saeed will be sheltered. They both are the same.
They are both important
anti-India figures for your army.
Padmaja.
G.D. Bakshi wants to respond. Just a second. G.D. Bakshi.
You know, Mayad, you are very right. He would not win an election in Pakistan, Hafiz Saeed. Unfortunately, he has the support of the most powerful constituency in your country, the ISI.
Exactly.
And as long as the ISI supports this man, you know, he is going to be a headache and a problem for the entire world. Number one. Number two point, you know, you said that Osama bin Laden was a creation of the United States, who rented out their territory for the CIA's war against the Soviet Union in Afghanistan. Your country, unfortunately, continues to rent out its territory to all and sundry. You invite extra regional powers and then you suffer in consequence. The problem is we have to suffer the consequences of your folly. Now you are renting out, the Americans are gone. You are renting out Gwadar port to the Chinese. How would you respond to that?
And in fact, this constant denial, this state of denial in the face of all kinds of evidence, Ambassador Neelam Deo,
I would have never thought, what can you really hope from Pakistan
when even now, despite the dossier whose details have been revealed, Pakistan continues to say that we do not know where Daoud is, to deny his presence in Karachi, Ambassador Deo. Padmaja, I'll respond to your question,
but let me talk to General Bakshi. Sir, I am sorry, I thought you couldn't have drawn such a parallel, that you're trying to draw a parallel between the Afghan jihad and now this economic corridor. Please don't draw analogy. This is strong analogy. There's no comparison between the two. Afghan jihad, we had a perfect situation for
disaster. Mr. Mayad Ali, you're going into history when the simple question to you was, if Daoud is, you're talking about how you have been victims, how you came to be victims of terror, when the simple question to you was that if you
want to demonstrate intent,
it has been proven Daoud is in Karachi, Daoud is in Pakistan soil, why do you not take action against him? Why do you not hand him over to India? That was the simple question. You continue to sidestep it, sir, and then you ask India, why is there trust deficit between the two countries? That's the very limited point I wanted to make.
I'm sorry, this is a debate
which is never going to end. I really have to take a very quick break now, sir, but thank you very much all for joining us on this debate this afternoon. A Times